welcome to our 2021 Active Minds graduation. And we are so glad to have everyone here today. This is a wonderful celebration, and we really want to take time today to honor all of the work that so many of the people who are graduating this year have put into Active Minds. And we've been able to have such a great and robust club due to their efforts. We really want to honor that today. Okay, so just for everybody here, obviously a lot of us know what Active Minds is already, but I just want to take some time to do a brief introduction. And I'll go ahead and start with that brief introduction talking about who we are. So hello, my name is Adriana Broger, and I'm a professor of digital media here on campus, and I am one of the faculty advisors. We have three other faculty advisors: Heather Bradford, who is a professor in counseling and wellness, and Nicole Sandoval, professor of communication studies, and Professor Annalisa Lagruda, who is a professor of psychology. And together we get to work with our students specifically on issues of wellness. So to give you some brief background on Active Minds, we often talk about how Active Minds was founded nationally when a young woman lost her brother who died by suicide. And she really felt alone and felt like there just wasn't a space to have conversations on college campuses about feelings of isolation and struggling specifically with issues related to how do I adapt to like this college setting and the fact that I'm changing, you know, my life is changing, maybe my family structure, all these different things are happening and I don't have a place to process that. And that's where Active Minds was born. So we are part of that national movement to really come to college campuses. There are over 500 nationwide. And here in our community in Stockton, we know that University of the Pacific has an Active Minds chapter. And so does Sac State and Stan State, where a lot of our students will go. So I only bring this up because I want you to know that if you love Active Minds on our campus, that when you transfer, please look for Active Minds wherever you go. And the main takeaway to the different things on this last slide, you see some images of places that we're going and things that we're doing. Here is the point of what we're doing is we are a presence on campus, whether it's a physical campus or a virtual campus, that really lets folks know that it's okay to talk about issues related to wellness and well-being. And we're here to change the conversation about mental health, to break stigmas, and to normalize the human experience. And those are really powerful things. According to statistics, just having an Active Minds presence on your campus will encourage other people to tap into resources that maybe they weren't before. So that's what we're all here to do. And we really honor your presence today, just giving you some brief background about what we do here at Active Minds. Next slide, please. Okay, great. So this one is just a year in review, because as we come to the end of this academic year, we want to talk about what have been some of the events that we've held this year. So what you see up top is a screenshot of a very, very nice Stephanie Rios, who is our vice president, is also our social media manager. And she's done an incredible job creating lots of great graphics that invite people. So we have this presence. Again, when we were a physical campus, we did all of that. And we still are a physical camp. You understand, right? We're moving virtually. So the idea is that we recognize that whatever way that we're serving students, mental health and wellness is going to be a priority. And so when we shifted online, we shifted to the virtual Zoom world, to these kinds of meetings, to let you all know that we're still here for you. And you see this reflected through games. Scribble.io has become a massively cool game. So thank you to our student leaders for introducing that to us. Paint and Sip has been awesome. And Pet Show and Tell, is just a really great way to connect with each other, get to know each other a little bit more. And topics of discussion that we've had have been many, but really focused on Suicide Prevention Month, as well as race relations. This year, we hosted two town halls, the AAPI town hall that we hosted just recently, and the Black Lives Matter town hall that we hosted in June of 2020. These are significant things to come out of a student group. So kudos to all of you student leaders, to all of you participants for being here with us and being willing to share your hearts and your minds with us and open yourselves up in these vulnerable ways to have these brave conversations. We also, continuing with our race relations, got a book club, and it's The Color of Hope, The People of Color Mental Health Narratives, that has been powerful. So thank you to all of you who've been involved in that. And we just want to let you know that if you aren't following us on social media, we're going to give you our handle towards the end so that you do follow us, because we continue the wellness conversation there as well in promoting wellness and then sharing resources across other existing campus clubs. So we collaborate enormously with the Pride Center, with ASDC, with the Dreamer Success Center, because we truly believe that our role as part of ASDC is to elevate that student voice. Thank you, Nicole. Next slide. And next slide is Heather.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to our virtual ceremony to honor our graduates from Active Minds and their friends and family that have joined us here this afternoon. Thank you, Ergiana, for such a wonderful welcoming and introduction to Active Minds. And Nicole, and also for Dr. Lonita Cordova, our new VP of Student Services, who is here with us today. Those of you that haven't had the privilege of meeting Dr. Cordova, you're in for a treat. She's not going to be able to be with us for probably very long. And when I confirmed her presence here today, knowing how busy she is in her new role here on campus, she thanked me for the friendly reminder, but said that, and I kind of apologized. I said, I know how busy you are. She is just leaving a board meeting, and she's just been busy trying to get herself acclimated to Delta and establishing all of the wonderful things that she's doing. But she said to me, my favorite part of my day is when I get to spend it with students. And so, with that said, I just am so privileged to welcome her here with us today. Again, she will share maybe a little bit about her background and why she's so passionate about mental health and wellness. Thank you, Dr. Cordova, for being here.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for having me. I'm excited and honored to be here. I have to tell you, mental health is I think it's a fabric of who I am because of where I come from. And so when given an opportunity to share space with students, I want to always share a little bit of my story because I think it's important for me in the position that I am to say, your past doesn't define who you are and define yourself first. And so just a little bit about myself. I was raised in Southern California. I'm actually biracial, half Black, half white. My mom is British. So I was born in London, raised in Southern California in Orange County. And that's important because for me, I come from a lens of a roots in Britain. My mom is got Southeast London mate, like a really strong accent. And then my dad is African-American, and that's a different culture altogether. So I always try to acknowledge that where possible. I also come from a place where I grew up in domestic violence. And at 17, I was in a physically abusive relationship. My first boyfriend tried to murder me and shot me twice in the head. And so surviving that, I joined the military to kind of get away and figure out who I was because my safety was at risk. That created a place where I could kind of be torn down and built back up again. Mm. And ironically, I was an information systems technician in the Navy for 8 years. I was running a network. So I was a network administrator. My bachelor's degree is information systems management, and I minored in sociology. So you could tell I always had that grounding in social work and the service spirit, but the logical thing to do was to get that degree in computer science because it's what I did in the military. When I separated, I ended up in my sister-in-law's first grade classroom, and she was walking around, and she's a really positive teacher. So she's saying, you know, oh, Adrienne, I really like how you're smiling and you're listening. And Heather, thank you for sitting up in your seat. And I thought, this is what I want to do. I'm going to paint pictures and sing songs all day. And then I went into substitute teaching and realized that is not what kindergarten and first grade teachers do. And I shifted gears and I ended up teaching a multiple subject. I got my multiple subject teacher credential through CSU Stanislaus. And I was I taught ninth grade at Weber Technical Institute for 4 years. I then went on to get a master's degree in counseling because during lunch and all my passing periods, my students were coming to me and sharing their challenges and needing support. And I knew that it went beyond just the curriculum and the day-to-day work. That's where I really started, you know, realizing the need for social emotional supports. And I know the work that I had to do on myself first. So I'm a product of self-help and reading and journaling and really trying to use that reflective, introspective approach to life. I ended up working for Foster Youth Services after I left teaching ninth grade. For 8 years, I worked in the ONE program. I'm not sure if you're familiar with alternative education. I worked for the San Joaquin County Office of Ed. And I worked at Mary Graham Children's Shelter. I worked at Juvenile Hall and then in some group homes, as well as helped to do transition plans for students moving out of the camp long-term facility back into their local districts. And so my heart was just in this work. And unfortunately, one of my students got 150 years in prison. And it was at that point where I just needed to do something and shift gears. I'd finished my PhD in psychology. I got licensed as a clinician. And I knew that community college was where my students would start. When you think about Maslow's hierarchy of needs, when they're in that place where they can reach that education point. And so I was very intentional with doing a bunch of work to get into the community college. Long story short, I've been a road traveler for 7 years to get into this job. And Heather and I met at Pete's one day, and it was like a soul connection. I was buying my coffee. I had on my ONE school shirt, and we looked at each other and she goes, "You work for the ONE schools." And we just, from then we were instant kindred spirits, soul sisters. I went to her Puente program. I would talk about wellness and mental health, and we've just kept that connection. So I share all of this with you because you will not have a linear path, and that's okay, because everything that you learn in life is going to lead you to where you're meant to be. And so knowing that and having faith in that is where hope comes from. Hope is a predictor of success. And I want to instill that in you, that if you're feeling a little anxious about graduating, if you're feeling anxious that you don't know what you want to do, I still don't know what I want to do when I grow up. I still think about like, where can I stretch myself? Where can I challenge myself? And so I really do mean it when I say, you know, being with students is, it feeds my spirit. It reminds me of why I do what I do, because, you know, you're always going to have those hard days and hard conversations, but you guys are the reason that I'm here. I know that I was kept on this earth for a reason. And so, you know, I want to thank you guys for allowing me to share space with you today. I will put my information in the chat because I am all about mentorship. I would not be here and I would not be me if I would not have had guiding people in my life. And so I want to just share my information with you so that if you ever want to reach out and talk through a career change, talk through college, whatever it is, I'm here as a resource. And you know, I'm so excited for you guys. I'm excited to be a part of your journey, but you know, to encourage you, because had I not taken certain calculated risks, I would not be where I am today. At 17, when I was going through one of the darkest periods of my life, had you told me I was going to be a vice president at a college, I would have laughed at you, honestly. And I can tell you, when they picked me for this job, when they called me for the interview, you could ask Dr. Porz and Johnny, I was just this little biracial girl from Orange County. I was honored. So I want to spill that into you today. Like this is the beginning, but it's not the beginning. Like just keep pushing forward with your goals. I'm going to pause there and see if there's any questions, and I don't want to take over your agenda. So Heather, whatever you need, let me know. And I'm going to just pause. questions. You guys can ask me anything. I'm actually pretty much an open book. So do you guys want to ask me anything?
Well, I already knew most of that story that she shared, and she's correct. When I met her was when she was in a teacher at the one school. So how many years ago has that been now, Dr. Cordova?
2009, maybe 10. So about 11 years. Yeah.
So yeah. And I will tell you our conversations over the years that everything that she has done has brought her full circle for this to happen, for her to be with us in this role. And so sometimes when you're going through different things, you kind of wonder, why am I here? Why am I going through this? Why am I doing this? And I always feel that everything that makes you who you are is a culmination of all of your experiences, everything. And so don't think that anything is going to not be an opportunity for a learning lesson, for something that's going to help you grow, and for something that's going to prepare you for whatever it is that you have in your future. So we're just thank you so much for sharing your story with us, for being here. You are truly an inspiration, and it's an honor for us to have you speak those words of encouragement to our graduates as they move forward in their lives.
Thank you. And I feel the same. So I appreciate the invitation, and I really mean it. Please reach out if you guys ever need anything. So I will help you in whatever way that I can. You guys enjoy the rest of your celebration. And I really, really appreciate being here today. So thank you.
Thank you. We have a lot of thanks going out to you in the chat right now.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye. All right, you guys enjoy. Yay.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye.
So the cords, look what I got you guys. These are our graduation cords, and I wanted to say that they're such a pretty color. There are Active Minds colors of green and blue, and the graduates that we're honoring this today and next Wednesday will receive one of these beautiful cords that they'll get to wear part of their graduation regalia, and also for taking pictures and so forth. So I just wanted to let you know that you will be able to pick up your graduation cord next week on Wednesday. We'll have those there to you prior to the event at 12 o'clock so that you'll have a chance to wear them during the drive-through graduation next Wednesday. So any graduate in the future, this is what you have to look forward to. One of these. They're really pretty. So we're going to go ahead and continue. And Nicole is going to go through our graduation and honorees one by one, and starting with the first one. And I'll turn it over to Nicole Sandoval at this time.
Congratulations, everybody's graduating. Woo! So excited for you. We are here to honor you today in Active Minds. We would love to congratulate Katrina Springs on graduating. Katrina will be transferring to Sacramento State University in the fall with pursuing a degree in psychology. She has earned an AS in psychology at San Joaquin Delta College. All right, hey. Katrina. One of her memorable moments was when she first began her journey at SJDC. She knew no one on campus. She made a counseling appointment with Heather Bradford, where she first was introduced to Active Minds. And the club recommendation changed the course of her educational journey. And she is so grateful.
Can I just add one little thing? Sure. I know I don't mean to interrupt. This is we're not trying to hopefully make this too formal, but I will also remind her, because I think Katrina did put this together late last night, and I wanted to give kudos to Professor Annalisa Lagruda, because actually it was also her coming to my counseling class to do a presentation that Katrina was in the front row that day, taking in every bit of information that you had to share about your mental health specialist certificate program and the placements and the work that you had done. And that counseling appointment that she made with me actually confirmed for her what she wanted to do. And so I just wanted to say thank you for that presentation, because I think you also inspired her in a big way.
Thank you. I'd love to inspire the students to consider mental health as a career goal.
All right, Katrina, shout outs. Here we go. Thank you to all the Active Minds advisors. It's been an amazing experience to work with an amazing group of women who have so much wisdom to share. I want to give a special thank you to Heather Bradford. You've made my college experience so much better than I could have imagined. Thank you so much. Woo, woo! Congratulations, Katrina.
Thank you, guys, and thanks for hosting.
Oh, we want to send a big congratulations to our next graduate, Stephanie Rios. All right, shout out to Stephanie. Stephanie will be transferring to Sacramento State University in the fall to pursue a degree in psychology. She earned her AS in psychology at San Joaquin Delta College. All right, memorable moments from Stephanie. I think there are too many to tell. I very much appreciate the times working alongside Katrina when we would get together on Zoom and plan events for each month. I love doing the in-person events when we would have our events in the quad. Yes. I love being able to have this 1 hour each week dedicated to wellness and calmness. We definitely needed it during these times. And this is an inside joke to Katrina. It's Dr. Katrina. She'll get a kick out of that. All right, doctor. Okay, I see more degrees in the future. All right, shout out. Here we go, Stephanie, shout outs. I don't think I have the capacity to do that here. I just love to give a million thank yous to our wonderful team of advisors. Thank you for taking the reins in March of 2020 when the world was falling apart and creating an amazing online wellness space. Thank you so much for your limitless support and love. Thank you to Ms. Broger for believing in me from the beginning. Literally from when I walked into Shima 146 in the fall of 2019. You pushed me to pursue a leadership position and let me have fun with my creativity. Thank you for everything. Thank you to all of our wonderful ActiveMinds members for showing up and opening up to us. Thank you for supporting Katrina and I. Thank you for letting me have this platform and share advocacy towards something so important to me. Lastly, thank you, Katrina, for putting up with me when I would text you lists of ideas and graphics. You know how much I appreciate you. Can't wait to continue working with you. Hashtag Hornet Gang.
Yay!
Yay! Congratulations, Stephanie!
Yay!
All right, we'd like to give a big congratulations out to our next graduate, Colby Love.
Woo!
Yay, Colby! CJ says, I plan to transfer to a university and find out more about myself and the world. CJ earned an AA in social sciences and an AA in radio television. Oh, hey, Colby, with your 2 degrees. Memorable moments. I think my favorite memory happened last year, just before the shutdowns, going to get a boba tea with a bunch of Active Minds and RTV members after a meeting. It was the first time in a long time I felt I was able to surround myself with like-minded people I could call friends in such a short span of time. Nice. Oh, CJ, nice. So sweet. All right, CJ, shout outs. Thank you to Adriana Broger, Active Minds members and RTV members for reminding me what I'm capable of, giving me the drive to sharpen my skills again, a sense of belonging while attending Delta, and for the patience and sensitivity you all handle everything with RTV work or mental health. It goes a long way. Oh, shout out to CJ. Congratulations, CJ.
Thanks, guys.
All right, we'd like to congratulate our next graduate, Lauren Ruiz. Woo! Congratulations, Lauren. Lauren plans to transfer to either UC Davis or Sacramento State University. She has earned an AS degree in psychology at San Joaquin Delta College.
Woohoo! Yeah!
All All right, Lauren, memorable moments. Back in spring 2020 semester, when we were still on campus, the club did an activity with colorful pipe cleaners. We had to pick four of these and make them into four shapes that represented a part of our identity. I believe the main idea of this activity was to reflect on who we are and how we would feel if one of these parts of our identity was taken away. I thought it was fun and a thought-provoking idea. It was interesting to see what other people created. I still have my pipe cleaners with me, and looking at them reminds me of this time. So sweet. All right, we'd like to, congratulations, Lauren.
Yay, woohoo.
All right, we'd like to congratulate our next graduate, Adriana Sanchez.
Yay.
Adriana plans after San Joaquin Delta College are to transfer in the fall to Stanislaus State to continue her educational journey for a bachelor's degree in administration of justice. All right, Adriana earned an Administration of Justice degree at San Joaquin Delta College. Congratulations, Adriana. All right, memorable moments. During Active Minds, my favorite memories were the rock painting and being able to see everyone's adorable pets through Zoom. Congratulations, Adriana. Congratulations to all of our graduates, everybody. We're super proud of you. We have enjoyed very much our time with you. Appreciate you all being here and spending some time with us each week. We are grateful for all of you and we wish you all well. All right. I'm going to turn this over to Annalisa.
So Active Mind student leadership. So let's talk about a president. And these are the positions that we will have coming up for the fall. And so a president who is responsible for overseeing the chapter's operations and supervising the other chapter leaders. They will be able to they will be the face of our chapter and will represent the group to the campus and local communities. The president shall preside over meetings. And so this can be a really fun and exciting position, especially if you're going into the field of psychology and maybe hopes to become a therapist. This gives you the opportunity to kind of test out your skills that you're learning possibly especially if you're going for the certificate as a substance abuse counselor or mental health specialist, gives you opportunity to test out your skills. And you can ask Katrina about that because I think she was given the opportunity to test out her skills a lot. Mm-hmm. And also Stephanie. Our vice president, who oversees all internal operations of the chapters, ensures that our chapter leaders and members have what they need to accomplish their goals. The vice president shall preside over meetings when the president is unable to. And so this can definitely be a position where you will also be able to practice a lot of your skills if you're going into the field of psychology and hope to become a counselor. That you'll be able to practice those skills. This is also an opportunity where you can build a very strong working relationship with the president and have a lifelong friend, such as I think Katrina and Stephanie are both going to be lifelong friends. They're going to most likely become strong colleagues once they get their degrees and enter the professional field. We also have a secretary for our club, who is responsible for maintaining the notes and records of all of the activities of the chapter, including our meetings, events, and members. And so again, can be a really fun, if you're somebody who likes to keep notes and stays organized, this would be a perfect position for you. And it helps us faculty advisors stay organized too when we have the secretary that's doing this for us. We also have a treasurer who's responsible for establishing and maintaining all financial records for the chapter. They must work closely with many different officers to ensure that the chapter has the funds necessary to accomplish its goals. And so this can become a really important position, especially if hopefully we get to go back onto campus. And so sometimes when we're on campus, we are in our meetings, have little snacks and things like that. And so you'll kind of oversee that or just other supplies that we need for face-to-face kind of activities, such as those pipe cleaners that we used for one activity, or the rocks and the paint that we needed to paint our treasures. We also have an ICC representative who is responsible for attending meetings corresponding with San Joaquin Delta College's student activities when necessary. And then we have a public publicity chair who is responsible for promoting a positive image of the chapter to campus and to local other local community by creating material and cultivating our social media presence. And so this is where if you are going into radio or in Professor Broger's class, this is your chance to shine and show all that creativity. Or if you're not going into that field, but you do have creativity and you love social media, this could be the perfect position for you. So those are the positions that we would love to fill. So when we start our new year in the fall. Thank you.
Can I just add, Annalisa, that the, you know, to our officers in the future, if you're considering a position with Active Minds as one of the student leadership roles, that you have a team of faculty advisors who are supporting you and are making sure and ensuring your success in those roles. We understand it can be kind of scary to think about taking a leadership role if you've never done such a thing before, but that's where our role comes in to support you. So you're not doing this alone. So in our case, unlike many clubs that may only have one faculty advisor, you have four very passionate faculty advisors to support you. So you have a lot of help and encouragement to grow in that capacity of student leadership. So I just wanted to add that.
Oh, and I have one more thing to add.
Out there and expecting you to succeed in this on your own.
Absolutely. One more thing to add. When the pandemic hit, Katrina was in my class, which is the field practicum class for her mental health certificate. Mm-hmm. And so one of the things in that field practicum class is you have to be placed in the community doing, practicing your skills at a facility. And so when pandemic hit, it hit a lot of people really hard in when they had placements or when they were attempting to look for placements. So I took the opportunity to use Active Minds as a place for Katrina to actually practice the skills that she would need for that class. So that is another opportunity where I could take on one or two people who are going to be in my field practicum class come fall, come spring of next year, that you can use Active Minds as your opportunity to practice your counseling skills, your organization, in order to fulfill your 80 hours of field practicum for my Psych 45 A and B. So consider that also.
So we have a wellness ambassador program at Delta College that we'd like to share with you. Katrina has been the wellness ambassador, or is the current wellness ambassador at San Joaquin Delta College. This is a position that is typically opened up by the chancellor's office. And so we're hoping that it will open up again in the fall. And that we can get folks to apply for this position once again and have a wellness ambassador on campus as we move forward, seeing Katrina off to her new journey. We'd love to see this position filled in the future by another Active Minds representative, officer, what have you, a part of our group here to be the wellness ambassador on campus. And provide resources to students and faculty. You can do peer outreach and advocate for mental health and wellness for students. I think it gives you a really nice platform for promoting health and wellness across campus. Also as being a part of Active Minds, but it's a really nice leadership position to be in to spread more awareness across campus.
And if I want to add too, this is a great opportunity. If you're interested in mental health, I'd really look into it. And just my experience with this program, I've gotten to know a lot of the people who work for the community, California Community College Foundation, and it's been awesome. And now that I'm kind of, my time's coming to an end at Delta, I'm looking back into what I can continue doing with them, and they have a lot of options there too. So I wanted to say that. So look into it, guys. It's worth it. And you get a stipend too. So it's fun.
Thank you.
Of course.
We wanted to remind everybody that today is our virtual graduation, but on May 12th, we will have a drive-through celebration graduation on campus, Bud One parking lot, May 12th from 12 to 2 p.m. So come and drive by and you can pick up your Active Minds graduation cord that Heather was showing you all earlier in our presentation today. Come join us, take a quick picture outside of your car, wear your graduation outfit. You know what I'm saying? Let's do it. Let's do it up. Drive through graduation celebration, May 12th. Come join us, everybody. Finally, you can always catch us on Instagram. This is our handle. I'm told this is a handle. Anybody who knows me on this chat here knows I don't do social media. I believe this is our handle. You can find us here. We do lots of things here. Stephanie's done a really nice job promoting us on this platform. We'd like to see this continue with our public person. What did we say the officer position was? Social media.
Yes. Public relations, social media. Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Public relations. So you can always find us here, everybody. And then lastly, we wanted to share with you our summer meetings coming up. We're going to have two. So we'll have one in June and one in July. And then that will take us to our first fall meeting at the end of August. And y'all can find us right here at the Zoom link that y'all are in right now. We're gonna start our meetings at 12:30 in the summer. And we are for sure playing that game that I like.
Scribble.io. Yes.
That is my favorite.
We're going to have to bring back the pipe cleaner activity since that was a big hit. We can do that virtually as well. We just have to be creative how we can mail out the pipe cleaners ahead of time to everyone. But that was a real, thank you for mentioning that activity. Because I had kind of forgotten about that back in those days when we used to meet in person. And even reminders about those nice snacks we used to have. I miss those snacks. Oh, Adriana's soup and our nachos and our ice cream cake we used to
The cookies.
Oh, and cookies. Wow.
Chocolate chip cookies.
Yes. Make sure you guys share with all of your friends and family and those that you know that are coming to Delta in the fall, let them know about Active Minds. We're here and we're gonna need to grow and continue to grow with more and more members.
I wanted to give an opportunity to let you all, you know, we wanted to give you all an opportunity to ask questions or concerns that you might have about the officer positions or anything, you know, that Katrina and Stephanie have done over the course of the year. If you're curious about anything, Katrina and Stephanie are open to answering some questions here before we leave today. So anything that you all are curious about, just speak now.
Oh, in the chat, how do you become an Active Minds Club officer?
Well, since we've been in the pandemic, it's been kind of different since in person, but typically we held like a meeting and every time we did, we got kind of lucky because it was like each one person for each position kind of wanted it. So it just worked out. But typically there's like a meeting held where, you know, like we'll announce like one person wants to run for president, say aye or nay. And then so it just goes like that. So probably you guys, I'm sure, will maybe talk about it during fall or the beginning or summer or something.
Mm-hmm. We will. So that's why we have that date already listed, because we know that we want to get together during the summer. And so if you're thinking about becoming a club officer, what we really would hope that you do, and I can actually put this in right now. I'm going to put in our Active Minds email. I would love for you to send an email so that we know to reach out to you. And so I'm putting this into the chat. And if you are interested in becoming an officer, please email us there. And all the advisors see the same email. So it's really helpful that way. I know in the past, sometimes you've emailed one of us individually, but this is really nice. So we all get to see it. And if you are interested, please go ahead and send us an email. That way we can reach out to you and get to know what it is that you're interested in doing. And we can help you so that hopefully when we meet up again at the end of August, we are just going to be able to formalize who is running so that we can hold elections very shortly after and get all of our board ready to go for middle of September is our goal to have everybody for the next year. Then you would be installed to help support the work that Active Minds does. Thank you for that great question.
Okay, thank you. I will email you then.
Excellent. Yay. Thank you.
Yeah, I'm going to send you guys an email too.
Yes. Love it. See, Lali, don't be shy.
Lali, come on. We're looking for your email, lady.
Right.
I'll see. I ran for another club, that's why. I'll see you, buddy.
Another yeah. club. There's other clubs?
No, I thought we were the only one.
We're the best one. I'm kidding.
Okay, well, thank you for asking those questions, but please do know that if the other part of this is that Active Minds isn't just the folks in the room here, because as a community college, we are getting a whole lot of new incoming freshmen this mm-hmm. fall. And so we want you to know, even those of you that are leaving Delta College, we encourage you to tell people when they say, oh yeah, I'm going to Delta College, please tell them, look up Active Minds. It's a club, it's open to everybody. And that way we really can grow. I know that I have reached out to a couple of high schoolers who are coming to Delta College in the fall, who are part of an Active Minds at an area high school. So I'm excited about them coming in. But I think, you know, it's just a constant checking in with everybody. So please know that if you're already leaving, just remind folks that we exist. Thank you.
If there's no other questions, I'll hand this over to Katrina and Stephanie, if either one of you have any final words you want to share. Otherwise, we can end for the day.
I'll say that I'll always be around. This is definitely not a goodbye. Next Wednesday won't be a goodbye. You guys are stuck with me. but also be around for future officers to help out in any way. And there's like, you know, little things that you learn on the way that I'd be happy to pass down. So thank you, everyone. Thank you for being here. And thank you for the celebration. It was really fun. And I'm looking forward to next Wednesday. The mask will hide my ugly cry. Oh, thanks, you guys.
So, yeah, basically, thank you. Yeah, thank you so much for this. I also... I'll be still working with the Pride Center through June, so I'm open to any, if you have any questions or anything, you can reach out to me. I'm still here with Delta for a little bit. Yeah, and I'm looking forward to seeing everybody next Wednesday. It's going to be fun. Pride Center is also going to be there, so it's going to be fun. Thank you.
Colby or Lauren, do you all want to say anything as graduates leaving us?
It's been like 9 months. Hi, everybody. It's good to see your faces and your voices again. It's hard to sink in. I'll probably still stick around for a bit. I might go for like one more degree at Delta before I peace out, but I'm just grateful to even be here, because this place actually helped me just feel comfortable at Delta, even after going here for a couple of years. I just felt like I was actually going here finally.
Hi. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for creating like this space, kind of similar to CJ. This club really helped me to feel more connected to the campus and to the school. And I just found it to be a really special place. And like I said, I'm grateful that I joined, and it's been really great. I appreciate you all. Thank you. And good luck to, you know, everyone in their future too. I know you guys will do really well.
Oh, you too.
Thanks everybody for coming to celebrate our virtual graduation here at Active Minds. We are, you know, just in gratitude to all of you and so proud of all of you as you're moving forward. We will look forward to seeing all of you next Wednesday at our drive-through graduation, where the music will be playing loudly. Look forward to seeing you next Wednesday, drive-through graduation.
Congrats, grads.
Everyone. Awesome.
Yay. Have a good one, everybody.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.